This guy was, he was concerned about, so he has two different houses. This was kind of another one of those things where he started throwing information at me, kind of threw up all over me. And so anyway, he has two different houses. He, long story short, he owes $14,000 on both of them. And he was like, well, what do I do? Well, he just said, I don't feel comfortable doing something where, you know, where I owe, my name is on the mortgage and I don't have a house. And I kind of just tried to explain to him how we do it, but I didn't really have an answer for him. And I actually got him to the point of a, just like an appointment and everything on Saturday. And then I realized that I didn't have all the information because it was such a weird thing where he had two different houses. So I was like, oh, well, what's the other address and everything? And I called him back and he's like, well, my son heard me talking and he's just going to take over payments. So I feel like if I had had something to answer to him, because he was uncomfortable with the concept of his name on there, but he doesn't have a house anymore. I mean, is that just not a deal? The kind of person that will never work with you? Or is there something I can say to him?
It sounds like what he did was with his sons exactly what you wanted to do with him.
Right.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
So I think one of these sellers snaked you on that deal. They took your model and he let his son do it. We've had this happen on this same call.
I didn't hear that.
So yeah, I mean, it happens out there.
Okay. So it wasn't really that I did something wrong. It was just he.
No, but to answer your question on what you could say, I mean, I would just be very upfront with them and say, yes, the loan does stay in your name. Now, is that going to keep you up at night? Because if so, we probably shouldn't do this.
Okay. So just be like, hey, yes, this is how it is. And if you don't like it, then that's okay. So you're just really upfront with them and
yeah.
Don't make
and
them feel like
if he says no, that's going to keep him up at night. He's got a problem with it. Pinpoint why. Why does that keep you up at night?
Okay.
And it's likely going to be boiled down to title is transferring, but the loan is staying in his name. And so you could then potentially suggest, well, what if I just lease the house from you? And then you convert it into a sandwich lease option deal.
Okay.
You see what I mean? Because then title doesn't transfer. Mr. Seller, it's just like you're renting out the house to me, but I've got an option to purchase it. That's the only difference.
Okay. So do you think in this case, it might make sense to call him back and say, hey, where you were uncomfortable, like maybe go through and like what you just said, why are you uncomfortable? And then give him the option of the lease or?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
In any situation or any conversation where a seller or a buyer or whoever has some objection, you always want to just really ask questions to pinpoint and drill down what is the actual underlying problem that they have? What is the objection? And then solve that problem.